Hello everyone, I hope you all are doing well. Today we are going to discuss few sums from exercise 1A, integers. In the previous video we have discussed about integers and properties of addition on integers, properties of multiplication of integers. So here we will be discussing few sums related to that. Alright, the first sum over here is, write all the integers between minus 9 and minus 3. Okay, now they are asking you to write the integers between both of these negative integers. Before starting further, I want you to just keep this in mind to represent all the integers on a number line. So whenever you are going to solve a sum, just imagine the integers on a number line. So here it is, this one is 0, and you know towards the right it is a positive integers, towards the left it is a negative integers. Now over here they are asking us for the numbers between these two negative integers. Alright, what are the two numbers? One is minus 9 and one is minus 3. Okay, left side to 0, we know they are negative integers. And what we have to keep it in mind? Each successive integer, if you take any two successive integers, the right number is always greater than the left number. If I compare 2 and 3, 3 is greater than 2. If I compare 0 and 1, 1 is greater than 0. If I compare minus 1 and minus 2, minus 1 is greater than minus 2. So similarly, minus 9 and 3, minus 3 comes first. So minus 3 is a bigger number, and towards the left if we go, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, minus 8, minus 9 comes, alright. So after minus 9 what will be coming? Not minus 10, minus 8. So we have to write those numbers. So what will be our answer? Between, so minus 8, minus 7, minus 6, minus 5, minus 4. Should we write minus 3? No. Because clearly the question says write all integers between minus 9 and minus 3. So we'll skip both minus 9 and minus 3 and we will write the remaining numbers. Alright. Simple another example. If I ask you to write all the integers between 1 and 5, what you will do? So both are positive numbers, positive integers. So simply your answer will be 2, 3, 4. I hope it is clear. Let's see another one example. That will be minus 1 and 6. If I ask you to find all the integers between minus 1 and 6, now we have one negative number and one positive number. One negative integer and one positive integer. You can see minus 1 is over here and 6 will come after 5 over here. So you need to skip minus 1 and 6 and write the remaining numbers. After minus 1 what comes? 0. So your answer will be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's it. Alright, quickly we will go on to the next topic. So next one is compare the integers. So question number 2, compare the integers. Now here you will be given two integers and they will be asked to compare them. What do you mean by comparing? Simply if they ask you to compare, you just have to tell which is bigger number and which is smaller number. Now you know in integers, if you take any two successive integers, the right number is always greater than the left number, right? Or the positive numbers along with 0 are always greater than the negative numbers. So you know that also. Okay, so minus 16 and minus 61, both these are negative integers. So both, if we travel towards the left of the number line, you know both these numbers are going to come. First what number will be coming? We will be coming to minus 5, minus 6 and so on, minus 16. Then we will be going to minus 61. So this one is minus 16 comes first and minus 61. How to say whether which number is first quickly? There is a small thing. Imagine both the numbers without their sign. So this number I will be thinking like 16 and this number I will be thinking like 61. Now you can easily tell which is a bigger number. Which one? 61. So clearly 61 is bigger. But this is not our question. Our question is minus 16 and minus 61. So what you do? Simply put minus 16 here and minus 61 here. Change the direction. So now it's clearly minus 16 is greater than minus 61. You take any example. Now if I take the next one, say minus 236. And minus 362. Now these both are bigger numbers and they are in negative integers. So how you will find out which is the bigger number? Forget about the minus sign. Compare only 236 and 362. If I compare 236 and 362, I clearly know 362 is bigger number, but the question is in negative. So that means minus 236 minus 362, minus 236 will be the bigger number. So that is how you compare two integers. You take any positive integer and you take negative integer. Say if I want to compare 4 and minus 2, clearly 4 is greater. Say if I want to compare minus 1 and minus 4, minus 1 is greater, so that is how you compare. Alright, we quickly go on to the next one. Question number 3. Question number 3 is finding absolute value. We've already discussed about absolute value. Absolute value. So first question, it says evaluate first one, 20 minus modulus of minus 11. Okay, what did I say? The question says 20 minus modulus of minus 11. Mod is nothing but, we have seen, absolute value of any number is the number itself regardless of its sign. Even though it is positive or negative, the number will be the absolute value. So here it says 20 minus modulus of minus 11. So here you are not supposed to do minus minus plus. Alright? So here clearly it will be 20 minus, what is the absolute value of minus 11? It's 11. So I will be writing 11. 20 minus 11, answer is 9. Alright? Next one, if I take another example, say I write minus 137 plus 30. So modulus of minus 137 plus modulus of 30. So how you will be solving? This is the mod. So absolute value of minus 137 will be 137, the number itself regardless of its sign. The next one is plus, absolute value of 13 is 13. 137 plus 13, 150 is your answer. Alright, quickly we will go on to the next one, that is question number 4. Alright, so the next one will be arrange in ascending order. Now here a set of integers are given to you and they will be asking you to arrange them in ascending order. Alright, so that is question number 4. What do you mean by ascending order? Ascending order is nothing but writing it from smaller number to bigger number. Okay, from small to big. Okay, now you know this one, this is the representation of integers on the number line. Starting from 0 over here and towards the left is the negative integers, right is the positive integers. When the integers are given to you, it's given in both positive and negative integers as well. So now you have to understand it that if I go right side to 0, that is all positive integers. If I go left side to 0, they are all negative integers. So if I go towards the left direction, the numbers are decreasing. If I go towards the right side, the numbers are increasing. Alright? So smaller to bigger number, if I have to go, I have to find the smallest number from the given integers. Which will be that one? Obviously, it will not be positive integers, it will be negative integers. So let's look for the negative integers, minus 9, minus 23, minus 37, minus 5. So you know if you go in this towards the left direction, minus 5 comes, then you have minus 9, then you have minus 23, then we have minus 37. That means the extreme left number on the negative integers will be the smallest number. Which will be that one? Minus 37. So I will be writing minus 37 is smaller than, now minus 37, minus 36, minus 35, we will be coming towards the right side. What will we will be coming first? We will be coming to minus 23. Alright? So minus 23, that will be the next bigger number. Because small to big we are going smaller, then usse bada, that is bigger. Then from there another one will be which one? Minus 9 or minus 5? Obviously what will come? Minus 9 will come left side. So that is minus 9 is bigger. Then from there who is bigger? Minus 5 is bigger. Alright, 4 negative integers, we have arranged them in small to big. Next one will be what? Once negatives is done, then we will come to 0. Do we have 0? Yes. So we will be taking 0 as well. So 0 is greater than minus 5. Next bigger number will be, we will be going to positive numbers. 11 we have 41, that's it. We have 11 and 41. Between 11 and 41 what comes first? 11 comes first. It means 11 is greater than 41 is greater. That's it. Simply you can arrange these numbers in ascending order from smaller number to bigger number. Quickly we will see what if we have to arrange them in descending order. If I take descending order, what do you mean by descending order? Exactly opposite to that. Now we will be writing it from bigger number to smaller number. To small. Okay. So in question number 4, ascending order one sum we have seen, and second one descending order we will see one more sum. And the question I will write it. Now the set of integers given to us are minus 24, 16, plus 16 that is, and minus 40, and we have minus 5, and then we have minus 13, 6 and plus 6 and minus 1. Alright. So in descending order, clearly we know we are going to look for the bigger number first. Bigger number means negative will be bigger or positive will be bigger. Positive numbers. So we will look for all the positive numbers, the highest positive number. What all we have? We have 16, we have 6. Which will be the highest positive number among 16 and 6? Clearly 16. So we will be writing 16 first. Now 16 is greater than next. From bigger to smaller we are going. What will come after 16? Positive way. 6. That is the next smaller number. That is 6. And that is greater than. Do we have 0 over here? No, we do not have 0. Then what will be the next one after that? 16 is done, 6 is done, then we will look for the 0. 0 is not there, so we will come for the negative integers. We have minus 1, so that will be the next smaller number. Minus 1. After minus 1, where we will be going to minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. We are going to look for the smaller number. We have minus 2, minus 3, no. We have minus 5. So that will be greater than, what will be the next smaller number? We have minus 24 and minus 13. Which number we will be taking? Minus 13. After minus 13, what we will be considering? The last leftover numbers of minus 24 and minus 14. What will be the next smaller number? Minus 24. The last one is minus 40. That means minus 40 is the smallest number. If you have only 40, that means that is the bigger one. But since there is a negative sign to it, so that will be the smallest of all the given integers. I hope you are clear with this one. Soon we will come. See the next topics and we'll go to exercise 1B. Thank you.